downtown Milwaukee, overcast skies, a threat of rain, so the roof will be closed tonight here at Miller Park as Comcast Sportsnet brings you Chicago Cubs baseball. It's the first of a three-game Mother's Day weekend series. The Cubs just dropped 3 of 4 in St. Louis. And great to have you with us, Jim DeShays and Len Casper. We just saw the Brewers, actually their only series win of the season. They took 2 of 3 against the Cubs last weekend, but Ron Renneke lost his job after a dismal start for Milwaukee, and they have hired 44-year-old Craig Counsell to manage.
Yeah, not a big surprise that Ron Renneke, one, got fired because they really tanked at the end of last year as well, and no surprise really that Craig Counsell was the guy who got the job. As a player, everybody thought he might ultimately end up in that manager's seat, a hard-nosed player, a grinder, always prepared, so he kind of fits the profile. And a good story in that he's a local guy too, from Whitefish Bay High School just up the road. His dad worked for the Brewers. He played for the Brewers at two different occasions.
And one of the latest guys to get the job without a lot of previous experience.
It's kind of a new paradigm in baseball, Len, these guys having not managed even in the minor leagues, getting big league managerial jobs. Osmus, Matheny, Ventura, there's a whole bunch of them.
All right, the pitching matchup is a rematch from Sunday. Jimmy Nelson for the Brewers and Jason Hamill for the Cubs each got a no decision. Hamill has never lost in his career to the Brewers.
Yeah, 5-0 lifetime and 7 starts against the Brewers. He's 3-0 in this ballpark. He pitched here twice last year in both of those outings, pitched 7 innings of shutout baseball.
Well, the Cubs had been hot. They rattled off 5 out of 6, but they've been a little cold here the last week, including that series loss to Milwaukee. They've dropped now 5 of their last 6. We'll have the series opener, Cubs and Brew Crew, next.
What's in a drop? The expectation of what comes next. That's what keeps the energy going. The drop refreshes the beat every time. So what's in a drop?
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
And priceless paintings disappeared.
And you would like me to find it?
Precisely.
10% of the insurance money.
Done.
Finding the world's most priceless painting will require the world's most unlikely players.
Do what it takes to bring the painting back.
You owe me a finger.
No!
Interested now?
Wildly interested.
Mordecai PG-13. Movies start at Channel 125.
Last week, Petey put on his little red hat and grabbed his shovel to plant his new tree. But Petey forgot one thing. He didn't contact Julie and took out the neighbor's cable lines. So they missed the big game. They're not happy with Petey anymore. He should have contacted Julie 2 business days before he started by simply calling 811 or going online at IllinoisOneCall.com. It's a free service. Don't be a Petey.
Everyone, Kelly Krall here in our downtown CSN studios. We'll get you back out to Miller Park for baseball in just a minute. But first, the Blackhawks series win against the Wild came at a heavy price. Defenseman Michael Roosevelt suffered a fractured left ankle during the second period of last night's game. The Hawks released a statement saying he will require surgery to repair it. He is not expected to return to full hockey activity until next season. Keep in mind, Roosevelt is in the final year of his contract. And now to some football news. The Bears opened rookie minicamp today. The number 7 overall pick, Kevin White, took the field for the first time in Wake Forest. Third-round pick, Hronis Grasu, officially signed his rookie deal. And second-round pick, Eddie Goldman, along with sixth-round pick, Teo Fabulaje, did not complete practice. Head coach John Fox did not give a reason why. But as for White, the rookie whiteout is already working hard to be a go-to target for Jay Cutler.
I just try to get on the same page with him, you know, try to catch every ball and just do my job. So, you know, if he's in trouble, he can come to me, or, you know, he just have trust in me. It'll be a lot better for me. I got to get more chances like that. If a quarterback doesn't trust you, he's not going to go to you often. So my job is to, you know, catch every pass and do what I can do. So hopefully I'll have a lot of trust from Jay Cutler.
Don't forget Bulls postgame live from game three against the Cavs coming your way after our Cubs coverage tonight on CSN. Up next, it's the Cubs and Brewers. Lynn and JD have the call. Enjoy the game, everyone.
Who says desirable can't also be responsible? With 46 standard safety features, the Lexus RX is proof that fun can be good for you. See your Chicago area Northwest Indiana Lexus dealer.
Get your party started with huge savings this month from American Sale. Right now, get up to 40% off swimming pools, up to 40% off hot tubs. And American Sale has everything you need to deck out your patio. We'll save on everything. And if that's not enough, right now till May 10th, we'll even pay your sales tax. The heat is coming, but the savings are already here, and we'll pay your sales tax. 9 Chicagoland locations. Visit AmericanSale.com and get your fun on.
This is history in the making. Cortez, 23 years old, first woman in the majors.
Never miss a moment. Uverse has more live TV channels on the go than cable.
Joakim Noah was lousy this year.
You're going to sign Pau Gasol.
What if I traded him for Kevin Love?
You would be hurt right now.
No.
Kevin Love.
Now I got a healthy guy that can step out and pick and pop.
It's okay if you want to get lit up, but just wait until you get drafted.
If you're going to do that stuff, I'm not naive. I know what these guys do.
It's second time this week you have brought up the name Ozzie Guillen in the context of Sox manager. That's not a discussion anybody's having, except for you.
Baseball on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by your Chicago area and Northwest Indiana Lexus dealer, who invites you to test drive a Lexus today. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, through it all. AT&T Uverse, find out what's possible with AT&T. Call 1-800-PICK-ATT, mobilizing your world. Ford, check out America's freshest lineup at your local Ford store or at localfordstores.com. And by Southwest Airlines. Book your low fare now at southwest.com.
The tailgating capital of the world, or at least of Major League Baseball. We don't mean that you drive really close to the car in front of you. We like to camp out early in the parking lot here, put stuff, various meat on the grill. But we're inside tonight. It's warm outside, but it looks like we might get some rain. As Matt Caesar will exchange the lineup card with Craig Counsell, the new Brewers skipper. They're 2-2 under Counsell after Ron Renicke was fired following that series last weekend, and the Brewers win their Friday throwbacks. That iconic ball and glove logo dating back to the late 70s.
Sharing a moment there at home plate. I think Caesar left the scrum a little early.
I want to do the before and after shot, JD, like you sometimes see with U.S. presidents. Craig Counsell has always looked like he's about 19 years old. He's 44, as I mentioned. But we might see a few gray hairs and maybe a couple of wrinkles over the next few years as a manager.
Absolutely, it takes its toll. Absolutely. He's kind of an intense guy, too. It's always the challenge. It's always the question when a guy starts his managerial career. Obviously, you have to know the game. You have to be able to command the clubhouse, have the respect of your players. But just how well do you handle the rigors, the highs and lows? But he seems to be the kind of guy that should be really good at the job.
Yep. And we want to welcome those viewers expecting to see the Reds and the White Sox. They are in a rain delay on the south side of Chicago. Here's the Cubs Southwest starting lineup. Dexter Fowler back in there. Didn't start yesterday. Chris Bryant hitting second. Anthony Rizzo, Miguel Montero, and Jorge Soler, 3 through 5. Starlin Castro's at short. Chris Coughlin is in left. Jason Hamill, look at that, 14 trips to the plate and has not struck out yet. Addison Russell in that nine spot as per usual.
And we'll take a look at the Brewers defensively. Chris Davis is going to be the left fielder. Carlos Gomez is a little nicked up, so Gerardo Parra is the center fielder. That's not a bad plan B. He's a Gold Glover, made a couple great plays in that series last weekend in Chicago. Ryan Braun in right. Ramesh Ramirez, Gene Segura, Scooter Jeanette. He's back in there. He came off the DL on Tuesday. Adam Lynn is at first. Martin Maldonado does the catching, and the Lexus pursuing perfection starting pitcher for the Brewers tonight is right-hander Jimmy Nelson. He's 1-2 with a 403 through five starts. And here's the oddity about Jimmy Nelson. This is his sixth start, and he's only faced three teams. And he went back-to-back with Pittsburgh, Cincinnati, and now the Cubs.
Bruce Dreckman, the veteran, will get home plate. Tom Hallion's the crew chief. He's at first. Alfonso Marquez at second, and Chicago native Dan Bellino over at third. And if tonight's Cubs leadoff man gets a hit, Binney's Beverage Depot will donate $100 to Make-A-Wish, Illinois. And it is Fowler against Nelson. And we're underway.
Ouch. Maldonado might have whiffed on that one.
We'll get it out of the way early. I think the Brewers should go back to these uniforms full time. This is the iconic Brewer look. Makes you think of Jim Gantner and Gorman Thomas. That ball driven deep to right center, way back for Fowler, and gone. And $100 to Make-A-Wish Illinois via Binney's Beverage Depot.
Wow, what a swing of the bat that was for Dexter Fowler. We talked so much about his approach at the plate, how he's willing to take pitches, work walks, hit the ball the other way, but every now and then we're going to drop this on you. Here's our Ford home run replay. A little low fastball, and he got that low ball in the air and gave it a long ride.
He's talking with his manager today, said really want to get Dexter going, and I guess prescient words from the manager as Chris Bryant gets a foul pop back to the seats. It's always a good start, right? The leadoff home run.
Yeah, that works.
For the team that hits it.
Yeah, that's a nice little ambush right there.
The 10th time Fowler has led off a game with a home run. The 0-1 to Chris Bryant misses. It's 1-1. Ramirez is not in their lineup. It must have been a very late change. Elian Herrera is playing third. That's right.
Well, Ramos has played one of the three games in Chicago last weekend. It's clearly not Ramos.
Looks like he's in Ramirez's spot in the lineup.
Boy, I hope so. Make a whole new scorecard. Yep. What, do you have a hamstring last weekend, Ramos?
Yes.
Kind of barking a little bit.
First two games of that series. Deep count, which is nothing new for Bryant. Foul tip, strike three. No, I think Carrera's actually hitting eight.
Oh, no. Well, it's a game of adjustments. We're just going to have to adjust. And there's a 95-mile-an-hour fastball from Jimmy Nelson. And so it's a right by Bryant.
Here's Anthony Rizzo. And a called strike. Sneak attack there against the shift with only Gene Segura on the other side of second base.
Now he has to work the two strike count, see if he can come back. That's his approach, to see how quiet the legs are. And Joe Maddon, we've talked about this a lot. Maddon continues to talk about it, how good his two-strike approach is. Jimmy Nelson, fastball, curveball, slider, change. The curveball's new for him. Developed it this spring. And it's become maybe his best secondary pitch. A good life on the fastball. You see sitting comfortably 94-95, throws four seamers and two seamers with a little sinking action. It's a fair number of outs on the ground.
Ball gets
away.
Rizzo's
arguing that the ball hit him.
And Rizzo said that it hit him in the foot. So Joe may ask for a replay here. But first he wants to talk with Bruce Dreckman. And ideally he would ask the other umpires before Joe has to use a challenge, right? Would anybody
yes,
else see
yeah,
it?
Anybody else see it? I don't know. We're looking at the replay in the video room here for the Cubs to see if they have a better look. And David Martinez says, no, we don't. Let's come on back.
Back to the mound, and Nelson will run it halfway over. Two outs.
Pick up your fire, boys!
Hit that shot in the Cubs dugout, and Chris Bosio was motioning to look at the ball. The guy's wearing the black shoes with black shoe polish. You'd see the shoe polish on the ball, and that would help press your case. Riz is wearing blue shoes. Do they have blue shoe polish? I mean, I don't even know if the shoes these guys are wearing are shoes that you would polish.
Yeah,
not sure what they got going on here.
I'm gonna guess no.
That doesn't look like a polishable shoe.
It doesn't. A strike called on Montero. And 423 over his last eight games. Yeah,
it's more of a cloth upper.
Yeah, they're more like athletic shoes as opposed to the baseball cleats you used to see.
But I think, you know, you get in the heat of a pennant race, it's time to start putting some polish on your shoes, regardless of the material. You don't want to give up that advantage.
Kind of a big league thing to be able to put polish on your shoes.
Yes.
One ball, two strikes. Nelson 6'6", 245, born in Oregon, went to high school in Niceville, Florida, and then the University of Alabama, second round pick, 2010.
Yeah, high expectations for Nelson. He's been among their top prospects for a couple of years now. Last year was really good at AAA Nashville and then got a chance at the big league level. Did not perform all that well here. It's not uncommon.
Swung on and missed. Strike three. A couple of K's in the first inning. The Dexter Fowler on the second pitch of the ball game took it up and out, and the Cubs lead 1-0. Milwaukee coming up.
Unboxing something great never gets old. Two helpings of juicy, thick-cut marinated steak inside of a grilled cheesy quesadilla with a side of chips and salsa. The new Steak Double Dia. Unbox it only at Taco Bell.
These are no longer cars. They no longer roar or screech or skid or speed. If a lion doesn't hunt, is it still a lion? Don't protect your car so it can look nice. Protect it so it can look mean. Don't fear the wear and tear. Be it. Just be ready for it. Turtle Wax Ice with Smart Shield technology. Protect the body. Free the soul.
Oh, come on, everybody. I think this is my grandson.
Little girl, you look so
lonesome.
I see you all feeling blue.
Come on over to my place.
Hey, girl.
We're having a party. We'll be singing, dancing, and singing. Come on over tonight.
Now the Brewers Southwest starting lineup written out by their new manager, Craig Counsell, in his fifth game. Segura, Jeanette, Braun at the top. Lind has been their hottest hitter. Davis and Parra in the middle. Maldonado, Herrera in for the scratch to Aramis Ramirez, and Jimmy Nelson batting ninth. Milwaukee 15th in the National League. That's last in batting average, .223.
Defensively, the Cubs set up shop this way tonight. Coughlin, Fowler, Soler left to right, third to first. Brian Castro, Russell Rizzo. Miguel Montero does the catching, and the Lexus pursuing perfection starting pitcher for the Cubs is big right-hander Jason Hamill.
Had a cracked fingernail during his last start, which was against Milwaukee on Sunday at Wrigley Field. He went six, gave up three, got a no decision.
The league bats .252 against him, and note just the two walks in 31 and a third innings of work.
You know how you hear the term, he's a professional hitter? You say that a lot, right?
Yeah.
Could we say Jason Hamill's a professional pitcher?
Professional pitcher.
Nothing he throws really wows you. He's been doing this for a long time. Good veteran presence in the clubhouse. Fair ball. Bryant cannot get Segura. And that'll be an infield hit.
Yeah, and I hate to go on the line already, but it seems to me that the Cubs have been victimized by just a lot of soft hits, bloopers, infield hits. There was a lot of it in that series against the Cardinals. And here we go again, a little ground ball to third base turns into a base hit for Gene Segura.
Well, not good to see him having success against the Cubs, but it is good to see Segura back on the field, and he only missed one game after that beating at Wrigley Field on Sunday.
And Pedro Strop got him right on the emblem in the batting helmet.
To the second time he's been hit in the head or the face by a pitch this year. Scooter Jeanette, who was on the disabled list when we saw the Brewers last weekend. This is his fourth game back. And a left hand laceration. Ground ball. Bryant to Russell. To Rizzo. They'll go around the horn. 5-4-3.
Yeah, that's a combination I think that Craig Counsell would like to play a little hit and run with if you got a little deeper into the count. Bryant was in at third base anticipating a possible bunt. like Jeanette actually tried to steer the ball through the hole on that side, but right to Bryant. He gets it started. Russell with the turn. Campbell with the applause. Boom, boom, boom. Double play.
And now it is Ryan Braun. And one hit in that series. It was a game-winning two-run homer on Saturday. And one for 12.
Jason shaking his head after that errant curveball. Primarily a fastball slider pitcher, but there are some games where he'll mix in more curveballs and the occasional changeup.
Just to go back to, you know, my point about a professional pitcher. Jason's not a guy you would consider a top of the rotation guy, but he's not a guy you'd consider necessarily a bottom of the rotation. He fits really nicely right in the middle. You'd match him up with just about any three or four in baseball. And you need guys like that to win.
Yeah, and for a stretch of starts, you know, he can pitch like an ace. I mean, he did last year in his time with the Cubs. He was quite good for a long time.
And ball four to Braun.
That being just the third walk he has issued this year, he came into this game with a whip, a walks plus hits per innings pitched of 1.02. That was 12th best in the National League.
One of the two Cubs starting pitchers grew up in the state of Washington, along with John Lester. Here's Adam Lind. He's from Indiana. Coming off back-to-back two-hit games, each including two RBIs and a home run versus the Dodgers. And good numbers against Hamill.
He's off to a very good start. Has an OPS up over 1,000. There's just a handful of players in the league that can make that claim. There's one of them, number 44 there.
And line the other way. Coghlan will pick it up. Braun trying to make third, and he will, as Coghlan will fire it to Russell at second. So two-out rally here. After the double play ball, the walk and the single, and it'll bring up Chris Davis.
Aggressive base running by Braun, going first to third on that base hit to the left. And I think a good decision by Coghlan. He was tempted and might have had a shot at Braun at third base, but of course the risk in trying to make that throw is you might allow Lind to move up into scoring position. He's already two outs in the inning.
Strike called on Davis. Snapped an 0 for 18 yesterday.
Yeah, very low batting average. He has plenty of power, but he's only hit one home run this year. But you have to respect his power. He does not get cheated. See?
Right on cue. Mentioned they're hitting 223 as a team. That's last in the National League, getting on base at a 277 clip. That's last. Second to last in earned run average, 4.75. 12th in fielding percentage. And a ground ball base hit into center. Braun will score, and we're tied. So that innocent-looking walk to Ryan Braun, little did we know that that would lead to the tying run. Two singles later, it's 1-1.
Talk about Davis and his big swing. This time he's willing to cut it down a little bit, stay on that slider. It wasn't a bad pitch. See it down outer part of the plate and down a little bit. Pings it right back through the middle. I don't make the hitting coach happy.
Still awaiting word on why Aramis was scratched from the Brewers lineup.
Tommy just had a case of hamilitis.
One on Parra.
Parra's had a fair bit of success against Jason Hamill.
Another base hit, this time to left. Here comes the throw to the plate. They're going to get him by a mile. And Lind is out. Aggressive send there by Ed Cedar. The only worry there was that Montero would panic and drop the ball.
Yeah, that was one of those two outs. Let's take a shot. Hopefully they make an errant throw. We can steal a run. If he had a timeout, he would have used it.
1-1 after one.
Checking two bags? That'll be zero extra dollars. Want to change your flight? $0 for that. Live TV? Tack on $0. Everyone who flies Southwest knows zero adds up to a lot. Book your low fare now at southwest.com.
Charge.
It's time to dehibernate at the Bass Pro Shop's Big Short Takeover. Buy one pair of Redhead or Natural Reflection shorts and get another 50% off.
Termites like to use stealth,
but I know all about their covert operations.
Using my flow meter, I apply the proper amount your home needs to help keep them from breaking and entering. Orkin, pest control down to a science.
If you had touchscreen navigation, all-wheel control, and a rear-view camera, where would you take it? The 2015 Mitsubishi Outlander Sport, now available with an adventurous 2.4-liter engine. Lease an Outlander Sport now for $179 a month.
Tomorrow on CSN, the gloves are off as Chicago goes under the lights for a primetime tilt with Milwaukee. Warm up with Cubs pregame live, presented by Fields Auto. It's Blue versus Brew. Cubs, Brewers, starting at 5:30 on CSN Chicago.
As your Blackhawks chart their course to the Cup, watch every shift, every shot, and every goal.
Then flip over to CSN as we break it all down for you.
Join us for Blackhawks postgame live, presented by Hawk Ford.
After every playoff game, right here on Comcast Sportsnet.
Jimmy Nelson ready to work against Jorge Soler, who swings and misses. 1-1 tie. Different ways to get a run. Cubs got one on a home run, two pitches into the game from Dexter Fowler. Milwaukee ended up with four hits and a walk off Jason Hamill. Could only get one. Soler off to a good start here in the month of May, batting 400.
Ouch. So Nelson making his second consecutive start against the Cubs. This is the trend. How about that? Two in a row against Pittsburgh. Very good the first time. Decent, but a loss the second time against the Reds. Really good. And then in Cincinnati, really struggled. That's his one really bad start of the year. And then last time out in Chicago, solid. And we'll see how it plays out here tonight.
Get the 2-for-1 special to start the season. Swing and a miss on a fastball at 94 for strike three. Now he has struck out three of the first five hitters.
Yeah, the rematch games, if you will, the second part of those previous two duets were both on the road. Here he's back in his home ballpark where he's been outstanding so far. allowed one run here in his previous two starts.
And Starlin Castro, really quiet with the bat here lately, 4 for his last 25, hitting sixth in the lineup, and a strike call. News out of Cardinals camp. They're in Pittsburgh this weekend without Matt Carpenter, who has been diagnosed with extreme fatigue. Remember, he left the game Sunday, this past Sunday against the Pirates in St. Louis, due to some lightheadedness. But he's had an accelerated heart rate and some dizziness, some dehydration, and he did not make the trip. So they're expecting him to rejoin the Cardinals on Tuesday when they're in Cleveland.
You know, I thought when we saw him that he looked really skinny, for lack of a better word. He's never been a big guy, but I wouldn't be surprised to find out that he's dropped a bunch of weight. Still playing at an unbelievably high level. Watch out.
That hit the bat, which is fortunate, I think. Even though he would have gotten first base out of it, you don't want to break a finger.
Well, Nelson's got very good stuff tonight. The fastball is really crisp. He's got a lot of run on it, and very dangerous when it's up around the head. Yeah, luckily able to get the hand out of the way.
Swing and a miss. A really good slider from Jimmy Nelson. Sunday night, tune in to CSN Chicago for a brand new episode of Beer Money. Watch the most exciting sports trivia show on television, where fans get to test their knowledge and try to win big. Starting at 7 right here on Comcast Sportsnet. Now Chris Coughlin. One more sartorial comment, if I may.
Yes.
And I'm done for the night. Can I claim Martin Maldonado is the most stylishly dressed catcher in the big leagues? He's got those gray shin guards on the road, and I like the color combo back there tonight.
Yeah, I don't like his gray one so much. I like this though. Reminds me of the Madrid Waddington Yellow Jackets.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. He's not afraid to do his own thing. I like that. Swing and a miss.
Yikes.
So Nelson gave up that leadoff homer, but since then he has fanned five out of six, I should say, and strikes out the side here in the second.
Wendy's new jalapeno fresco spicy chicken is so deliciously hot, it's generating reactions from everyone, like the memer.
Whew, eat spicy goodness like a boss.
The selfiers.
They're good. Gotta get a selfie.
So hot, gotta selfie your selfie.
And the behind the timeser.
This sandwich is da bomb. Raise the roof!
Wendy's new jalapeno fresco, our signature spicy chicken topped with fresh jalapenos and ghost pepper sauce. How will you react?
Why do I love coming to Chicago? Second City, the House of Blues, and Binney's Beverage Depot. Check out the prices, check out the volume, check out the enticements, check out these beautiful displays. If you can't find it at Binney's Beverage Depot, it's probably not worth drinking.
Lowe's presents How to Plan for the Future.
Happy Valentine's Day, happy birthday. Sorry I forgot our anniversary. Happy Mother's Day.
1.5 gallon hanging baskets, now just 2 for $16 at Lowe's.
So I'm having birthday brunch with my family.
When my husband hands me a present.
A Galaxy S6.
So I call my mom.
I have Verizon.
I don't. She couldn't really hear me.
I tell her how much she means to me.
But she thinks I said she was always mean to me.
I could hear how happy she was.
Well, she definitely loves my sister more.
Mother's Day is almost here. Now get $200 or more when you trade in your smartphone for a Galaxy S6. But hurry, this offer ends May 10th. Verizon.
A great statue of Mr. Baseball, Bob Uecker. It must be in the front row, which is actually in the back row. In our Xfinity high-speed action. He and his partner, Joe Block, Ken Sommerfeld, their fine engineer, they got locked into their radio booth. The doorknob fell off just the other night against the Dodgers. That's Mary Burns on the right. I guess she got a little nervous. And wouldn't you be nervous? She got locked into a booth with Bob Uecker. So they got the ladder out.
And, wouldn't have been better if Uecker just started climbing down the ladder.
And they had fun with it. Took them an hour and a half, I guess, to get out. And there they are tonight. Just a bit outside.
I think Peter Graves must have been the model for the Uecker statue up there.
Good call. Cut and a miss by Maldonado.
More Peter Graves. They should have put a hat and some shades on him.
Yep. This portrayal of Harry Doyle in the Major League trilogy, or did they make four of them?
I kind of lost track after two.
Is one of the funnier things that I've seen in the movies, and that's all Bob. You know, I think they basically told him, you do what you do. Yeah. You know, it was a little blue at times, which is very out of character for him.
Yeah.
Who cares? Nobody's listening anyway.
Well, his bits back in the day when he'd go on Carson.
He was Johnny's most frequent guest. Herrera runs to Russell. Bring up Nelson with two outs.
Well, don't know much about Nelson as a hitter, but we do know this. Anybody with a bat in their hand can be dangerous. That was proven again yesterday when John Lackey delivered a two-run double down the right field line. And just kind of a swing that was about 3 seconds too late. And hit it right down the first baseline and drove in two.
Some choking up on the bat. And it's one and two. Choke and poke. Did that a lot when I was in Pony League.
Yeah, that's the two-strike approach, yep. Right? Choke up and poke it the other way. Take two and go to right.
Full count. It's Segura on deck.
Remember trying to pick away at that outside corner now. He'll be willing to throw it right over the heart of the plate.
Ball strike three. They go down in order in the second. We're tied at one.
Get storage solutions for your home with Dakota Shelving. Pre-finished square-edge shelving is premium quality, decorative, and perfect for multiple applications. A 3/4-inch thick 8-foot shelf with an 11 3/4-inch width is $7.99. Keep your space spick and span with sturdy shelving units from Fundamentals. This 5-foot ventilated shelving unit is made with heavy-duty, high-impact resin and assembles in minutes. $34.99.
Save big money at Menards.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced, or descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
There's no place like home.
Getting home safely is just a click away. But making sure your child is in the right seat is just one of the steps down the road to safer travels.
I don't know how it works.
Find the right seat for your little one's age and size.
We've done what you told us.
There's no better way to get home safely. Know for sure that your child is in the right seat. Get all the facts at safercar.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
At MTB, get Memorial Day savings the entire month of May. Buy three tires, get one free instantly when you get them installed. Choose from Goodyear, Continental, Cooper, Nitto, and more. Get your Memorial Day savings now at your neighborhood MTB, home of the lowest tire price guarantee. Buy three tires, get one free. National Tire and Battery, that's all you need.
Hey, Cub fans, let's go. Don't miss all the excitement this season at Wrigley Field. The Cubs return home this Monday night for the start of a seven-gamer. The Mets and the Pirates will come in. Tickets are still available for every game. Get your tickets at Cubs.com. And a portion of the bleachers will open as well.
That's some good facial hair right there.
A 1-1 tie as Hamill, Russell, and Fowler will face Jimmy Nelson, who has struck out five here early on. Hamill, he's been Placido Polanco, Juan Pierre, Jeff Kepinger. Been a good contact guy here early on. Let's see if that continues. Yep. Base hit left field. 5 out of 14. And that's his 15th plate appearance, and he still has not struck out.
And I would say pitchers in the National League probably strike out at about a 50% clip, probably. We can look it up. Just the magic wand, he just waves it through there. Leg kick, double tap, little toe tap. You can set that to music. He's getting fancy.
Russell comes in with a 10-game hitting streak. Fly ball out into shallow center. And it's Gerardo Parra to make the catch. So let's see. I don't have plate appearances, but I have at bats for pitchers.
I've got to
do it wide. Do you have plate appearances?
No, but I got a strikeout rate. League average is a little under 40%, just under 39%.
So it's about double everybody else.
Yeah, and I wasn't giving pitchers enough credit. I was thinking about 50% of the time.
Fowler takes a strike. Switch hitter, he does take BP. Generally, same amount of swings from each side of the plate. So it might get tweaked depending on how he's feeling that particular day. But I saw him take some swings right-handed, even though he starts the game batting lefty.
You almost have to treat it like two different players. And that guy, that right-handed Fowler's got to get his swings every day, too.
Get Hamill, and that's it. Not an ideal result, but at least you got Fowler running instead of Hamill for Chris Bryant.
Yeah, and you know, at the end of the day, this may benefit the Cubs, because if Fowler steals second base, you'd much rather have him out there in scoring position than Jason Hamill. That means he has to steal second base. And Among their many woes, the long ball's been an issue. I like this kid's upside, though. I think he's going to be a good one. He gets a lot of swings and misses. Now that he's got that curveball, he's going to even generate more swings and misses.
Bryant has not had a ton of great pitches to hit, but when he has seen, quote, his pitch, he obviously hasn't gotten all of one as of yet. Clearly, it's the longest home run drought of his life. He's doing everything else well. Getting on base, running the bases.
Yeah, and I think, you know, sometimes you watch his at bats, and I think he's kind of just trying to guess along with the pitcher. You know, he's been seeing a lot of breaking balls, and I think there's been some fastballs that he hasn't pulled the trigger on, that once he's got a little more time in the league, we'll see him be a little bit more aggressive on some of these fastballs.
Well, he's got enough plate appearances now to qualify among the league leaders, and he's in the top four. And on base percentage, he struck out three times, walked once yesterday, fanned in his first at bat tonight. So four games of at least three strikeouts out of 19 total, but he has walked 17 times in those 19 games. Swing and a miss. 1-2. His manager thinks he just needs that first home run and he can relax a little bit. And as he said, they seem to come in bunches. Fowler runs, swing and a miss, inning over. Maldonado does not even have to make a throw. And that is strikeout number six already for Nelson. We go to the bottom of the third. It's the Cubs one and the Brewers one.
What's in a can? Possibilities. The beginning of something promising. Something real that will refresh your perspective every time. So what's in a can? That's up to you.
When the moment's spontaneous, why pause to take a pill? Or stop to find a bathroom? Cialis for daily use is approved to treat both erectile dysfunction and the urinary symptoms of BPH, like needing to go frequently, day or night. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and medicines and ask if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Do not drink alcohol in excess. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, get medical help right away for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, or any symptoms of an allergic reaction, stop taking Cialis and get medical help right away. Ask your doctor about Cialis for daily use and the free 30-tablet trial.
This is the day to live in all I've got. You.
Have a day to remember. It's easy with a free red velvet cake with a 10-piece meal or larger.
Tomorrow on CSN,
Chicago's out to scorch the scoreboard in a match with Real Salt Lake.
So stay inside, lace them up, and fuel the hometown fight all game long. Coverage starts at 1:30. Feel the burn.
Welcome back. We're going pink to promote breast cancer prevention awareness. This Monday, all fans in the Budweiser bleachers will receive a Cubs Charities Pink Out t-shirt presented by Advocate Healthcare. Cub players will wear pink batting practice jerseys. Those will be auctioned off to raise money for mammograms for underinsured and uninsured women. For more information, visit CubsCharities.com.
Segura sends one in the air out to right center, where Fowler is standing by. I got a couple of good tweets here. Gavin Welker checks in, asking about Jason Hamill's batting average versus his on-base percentage. Why is his batting average higher than his OBP? He's right now 357, but his OBP is 333. It's because he has hit a sac fly, which counts against your on-base percentage, but not against your average. So it is possible to finish a season or a career with a higher average than when you're on base. Jace Jenkins also asked why the innings pitched you see 0.1 or 0.2 as opposed to 0.3 or 0.7, which is actually more accurate. And I think the reason is just simplicity. Three outs in an inning, so it's either a whole number, 0.1, 0.2, it's just simple. I've seen it 0.3, 0.7 on occasion. A couple of different websites. So a third of an inning should be 0.333 of an inning, right? Not 0.1. It's a quirk of baseball. Two
could
outs.
Fractions.
I yes.
Look very good on the graphic. Right.
1/3, 2/3.
Yep.
Juan walked with two outs in the first inning and later scored on the Chris Davis RBI single. Ball one.
It's been low. He's on the plate. That's the adjustment Hamill's made since that first inning when he was getting hit around a little bit and gotten back on top. He's getting that fastball down in the zone.
Curve that time. 2-0. Roof closed, panels open. The flag's not doing anything, so it does not appear to be any sort of wind factor. I think he's thrown him a strike yet. He walked on four pitches his first time up.
I suspect Braun would be free to swing here on 3-0 with two outs. We'll never know. Carefully to Braun, he's the guy with a big resume on this club, but Adam Lind's a pretty good hitter too, and he's having a much better year. Lind leads the Brewers in just about everything right now.
Shallow center, and it's Fowler to end the inning. We head off to the fourth from Milwaukee, and it's a 1-1 tie.
Hey Jerry, nice yard. I bet this dead wood really hits home for you. The only thing getting trimmed around here our property values.
Does it ever feel like your yard work is taunting you?
Where you going? The nail salon's the other way.
Take back your yard with professional-grade equipment from Echo. Reliable, easy to use, and backed by a 5-year warranty. Echo. Get serious. During the Echo National Sales Event, get the SRM 225 trimmer for less than $200.
If you've been wishing for something amazing, Cricket Wireless has got it. The new Samsung Galaxy S6 for zero down on a phone payment plan and will cover your initial loan payment of $19.99. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
You like bacon?
I like bacon.
You'll want the DQ $5 lunch with a bacon cheeseburger.
I like bacon.
All for just $5.
The DQ $5 lunch, entree, fries, drink, plus a sundae. This is fan food.
I like sundaes.
Ford is taking the EcoBoost challenge all across America.
Ford has really stepped up.
Check out Fusion and find out why Ford is the brand more people buy and buy again.
And I like the grill and the sexy look to it.
EPA estimated 37 miles per gallon on the highway.
Are you serious?
fusion is amazing.
My opinion of Ford has dramatically changed.
Now for a limited time, get a Fusion with 0 for 60 plus 1,000 cash back, plus 750 cash if you own a Ford or qualifying competitive vehicle, or lease one for 179 a month.
Sunday on CSN, get ready for an all-new episode of Beer Money. Each week, join Jen Letta and Luke Stuckmeyer as they quiz contestants on their sports trivia knowledge. Win big or go home. Beer Money, presented by Coors Light. Sunday at 7 on CSN Chicago.
The best mop in any press box in baseball right there. Patrick Mooney, and you can follow our Cubs Insider all season long on Comcast Sportsnet, brought to you by Nationwide agent Jeff Vukovich. Visit Jeff at jeffvuk.com. Nationwide is on your side. Breaking ball for Nelson to Rizzo for a strike.
Yeah, that's a pretty good salad that Patrick's rocking there, isn't it?
Indeed. Rizzo was depositing balls into the upper deck with right. And I think he just did it again. I was talking about batting practice. Way gone. Two to one.
Speaking of prescient, good call. Now, he's been on a bit of a power surge here lately. He's been really good all year long in terms of the approach at the plate, working his walks, hitting for average. And the power has been on display here of late. This is a no doubter. A weird night for Nelson, dominant with the strikeouts, but he's made a couple of mistakes and the Cubs have made him pay. First Fowler, now Rizzo. There's your Ford home run replay, and that is that gorgeous uppercut swing that he has.
Fair ball for Montero. Racing to second. And he's in with a standing double. Good start to the fourth.
Boy, if you could bottle this swing, huh? And this is just a thing of beauty. Here it is from overhead. It looked like Maldonado was reaching back for another ball from the home plate umpire. So Rizzo made contact.
That's right. Where he was hitting balls around 5:30 today, making loud noises off the bleachers that were empty at the time. Runner at second, nobody out, and low and outside to Soler. Rizzo has now hit six, and half of those have been on this road trip. By the way, they have rained out officially, or postponed that game in Chicago. Reds and White Sox will play a double dip tomorrow. Inside to Jorge, or Georgie, as his manager calls him.
Noise by Rizzo, off-field double by Montero, and all of a sudden Nelson a little gun shy of the strike zone.
High deep drive to center. Parra going back, still back, it's gone. Two-run blast for Soler, and it's 4-1.
Hurry up and review the Ford home run replay. They're coming in bunches tonight. Third long ball of the night. Soler, a towering home run. Just a little right of dead center field. There you go. 3-1. Looked like a fastball, maybe a little cutter. That's a strong man to hit it that high, that far.
Cut and a miss by Castro. Number three on the year for Soler. The first two came in the same game in Cincinnati on or at Wrigley against Cincinnati on April 13th. After Leak and Diaz. So it had been a while.
Expect the Cubs to be a team that hits a lot of home runs this year, and they came into this game with 21, tied for 10th in the league. So, you know, by the time all is said and done, they'll be among the league leaders in that category.
And it's still buzzing in that Soler blast.
The league average allowed is 25. The Brewers have now allowed 45 long balls.
Two and two.
And coming into the start, Nelson had allowed just one. Talked from the outset about what a good ground ball pitcher he has been.
Can't always count on hitting a ton of home runs, but when you do, it sure makes life easier for everybody. Swing and a miss, he got him with a slider.
Starlin's really been out of whack here lately. See how much he's drifting towards the third base dugout. Got no chance to get to that slider.
Real happy at the moment.
He's got to get back into just trying to stay on the ball, hit it hard the other way. Once that starts to happen, then generally good things develop from there.
In the 1-0 is outside. A problem for Parra. Doesn't have enough plate appearances to qualify for the batting title. But he is hitting 357. They do have a silver slugger for the pitcher, though. He's on the early leaderboard. Slugging 429. Chop foul to Gary Jones. Nicely done. And Cup fan going home with a souvenir.
Well, there's no way she wasn't getting that ball. Young kid, Cub shirt, pink cast. That a girl? Nelson struck out the side in the second, just 12 pitches, worked a little harder in the first. Weird night, as I said, because his stuff is really good. He's just made some mistakes, and the Cubs have jumped him.
Almost strikes out for the first time this season, but Rizzo and Soler making a lot of noise. Leadoff homer by Rizzo is sixth. Two batters later, Soler with number three. 4-1.
The ultimate backyard party starts at American Sale. Get the lowest prices of the year on patios, pools, spas, and playsets. You'll save on everything. 9 Chicagoland locations. Visit AmericanSale.com and get your fun on.
Take the plunge and save at American Sale. Right now, get up to 40% off swimming pools. Hundreds of styles and designs to choose from. You choose the shape and size. Your kids choose to cannonball or just jump in. And American Sale has everything to deck out your patio. Save on everything, and we mean everything. Take the plunge into summer with huge savings this month at American Sale. 9 Chicagoland locations. Visit AmericanSale.com and get your fun on.
The switch to T-Mobile is on. Even Verizon customers are seeing the light. T-Mobile has America's fastest 4G LTE network. From the Bay Area to the Big Apple. And more data capacity per customer. Need one more reason? Get two lines of unlimited 4G LTE data for $100. Save without settling on America's fastest 4G LTE network.
Did I miss out?
No, our sales event is still going on.
I called in sick.
I get it. You don't want to miss the great deals.
Luckily, my boss is out sick, too.
Mitchell?
Sir, I thought you...
What goes on at the sales event stays at the sales event.
Let's look at some cars. Let's do it.
Right now, get 0% APR financing for 60 months on a new 2015 RAV4. Or lease RAV4 for only $199 a month. Hurry in today.
Wow, I got a great deal.
Thanks, Jan.
Feel better now?
Toyota, let's go places.
Our AT&T U-verse multi-view. The Cubs home run hitters here early on. They have tied their season high with three. Hit three at Colorado on April 11th. Hit three more versus Cincinnati 2 days later. Both of those games were wins. In fact, the Cubs have only lost one time when they've hit at least two home runs. 5-1 on the year. The word on Aramis Ramirez, scratched late with lower back stiffness. That's why he's out of the Brewers lineup. Jonathan Lucroy still on the DL. Carlos Gomez not in there tonight. Strained right hip. So they're 9-20 and they're not fully healthy either. Reed swing and a miss, strike three.
Is that right by him?
On Saturday, May 16th, the Cubs will host the Pirates at 3:05, and the first 20,000 fans in attendance get a reusable tote bag presented by the MLB Network. For more information or to purchase tickets, visit Cubs.com. Darn it, I was hoping there was a picture of Dan Plesac out there.
You don't even have to pledge to get your tote bag. So what was it, your factoid? If the Cubs hit two home runs, they're 5-1?
Yes. They hit three, they're 2-0.
The Brewers are 0-9 when Gerardo Parra starts in center field.
0-9.
That's more to do with the fact that that means Gomez isn't in the lineup. It's such a valuable piece for them than it is an indictment on Gerardo Parra. But those two factoids alone, that the combination of those two, I mean, it's a slam dunk.
2-1 to Parra. He has been hot as of late. Well, apparently it hasn't mattered. He's actually been good in the pinch, but he's hitting 400 in his last 11. He bounces one toward the middle, right behind the bag. Castro fields, and he gets him by half a step. Donato, the catcher,
So Craig Counsell gets named the manager last weekend. His very first game is against the Dodgers in Clayton Kershaw. That's not exactly a soft landing. The Brewers won that one.
They came back late.
Yeah. So there was the requisite. Yeah, we've got a different energy, a different spark. We've got an edge now after that win from the players. Seems kind of silly. One game in. A heck of a win against, you know, one of the better teams in all of baseball, against the best pitcher in all of baseball.
An alum of Notre Dame. Mentioned he's from here in Milwaukee. Played for a bunch of different teams. And the Marlins and Diamondbacks, 97-01. How about being a big part of two game-winning rallies in the final half inning of Game 7 of the World Series?
Yeah, he's, you know, a tremendous defensive player. Didn't do a whole lot offensively, but gave you a tough at bat. Hit for a decent average, but very little power. But, you know, again, one of those guys who didn't play every day, always made a contribution. Smart guy. Figured he'd end up either managing or running a club, and, you know, from the front office.
NLCS MVP in 2001. Remember a series. One time, a three-game series, he started at second, short, third. He was, you know, versatile. Very bright guy. There were some who speculated he might be the GM and not the manager, as he was working alongside Doug Melvin. He was doing reports on their double-A club, and he got hired. He still hasn't turned them in. He said, that's low on the priority list.
But that's one, when Doug Melvin was asked about the hiring, he said one of the reasons he really liked Counsell, aside from all the things we've talked about, is the fact that he has been in the organization working alongside of Melvin for 3 years, knows their system very well. So young players come to the big leagues, he'll have a pretty good idea of what they're capable of, and there'll already be a relationship there.
So, is there a thread with this trend? Ventura, Matheny, Ausmus, Counsell, that if you surround yourself with experienced guys to help you with the in-game stuff, that it's more about, well, kind of the rest of the stuff?
Yeah, I think there's, I haven't hired any of these guys, but I'm guessing, yes, that's a lot of it. Let's get guys who have automatic credibility in the clubhouse because they've had good playing careers.
Talk more about it as we continue, as Jason Hamill has a 4-1 lead into the fifth.
On behalf of Southwest Airlines, welcome to Chicago.
Let's go, let's go.
All right, don't everybody get up at once.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me.
Door.
Seriously, we can't miss you if you don't leave.
Once again, we have landed. Welcome. Thank you so much. Come back and see us.
Sometimes flights end before games do. Watch free live TV on your own device. Book your low fare now at southwest.com.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
Our lives are not fully lived if we're not willing to die for those we love.
Uncle Larry!
There's our girl!
And for what we believe.
Mr. President,
people are dying.
You got one big issue, I got 101.
Sam was the place.
This is the next great battle.
What happens when a man says enough is enough?
Selma. Movies start at Channel 125.
And here we go, folks.
It's your favorite hot dog bun, mustard, and overpriced watered-down beer.
Are you sure you want to eat all that? Because you already weigh more than your team's batting average.
Let's just toast to our anniversary. Oh, no, it's corked.
Let's just watch the game. I tweeted all of your friends to come over, but I guess no one showed up.
That's okay. I invited one of your friends, too.
It's out of here.
Give a real anniversary gift this year. Escape to the Champagne Lodge in Willowbrook. Book your next special memory at the Champagne Lodge today. You know you deserve it.
Comcast Sportsnet, your home for Chicago Cubs baseball.
Tomorrow, Travis Wood takes the hill as the Cubs battle these Brewers in game two, and our coverage starts at 5:30 right here on CSN Chicago. Jimmy Nelson has had a very strange night. He has struck out eight. He's given up three home runs. As he faces Addison Russell, I talked to Addison today. He went to zero major league ballparks as a kid, as a fan. First time he was inside a major league park was in the Under Armour All-Star game in high school at Wrigley Field. So this is a very new experience for him. All these road trips to St. Louis, to Milwaukee. I envy him because he's 21, he's in the big leagues, but I also envy him walking into these parks for the first time.
Yeah,
because
there's young and
nothing like that, right?
Young and kind of innocent. Stay gold, Pony Boy.
1-1.
Yeah, every trip, every new ballpark is a brand new experience.
Forget walking into Tiger Stadium for the first time when I was a very young kid. And nothing replaces that first memory of walking through that tunnel, seeing the green grass and the grandstand for the first time.
Yeah, the video they play at the Wrigley before each game, Bill Murray talks about that. First time coming to Wrigley. For me, it was Jerry Park in Montreal. It's the greenest green you've ever seen.
So finish up the thought about former players without a lot of managerial experience. I think number one, part of it is it's hard. And Ryne Sandberg is a huge exception to the rule. Kudos to Rhino for managing for 6 years in the minor leagues before he got the Phillies job. Swing and a miss for number nine for Nelson. But unlike 20, 30 years ago, J.D., any player who's had any sort of big league time has all the money he's probably ever going to need. So if you're a guy with 10 years in the big leagues, why do you want to tell your wife you made $72 million, I'm going to go manage in a single A ball. I've got two kids who are 9 and 10 at home. Mm-hmm. That's very difficult to do.
Especially without a promise. It's one thing if they say, go down there and then just ride the buses for a year or two, and then we'll bring you back in some capacity, whether we feel like you're ready to manage or put you on a big league staff or bump you upstairs to, guys who've made a lot of money in the game. It's going to be rare for them to buy into that going forward. Now, that doesn't mean you have to have guys with big, former major league players with long careers. But I think there are some GMs now that see a lot of value in that. New managers don't have to earn the respect of their players because of their playing careers. When you think about so many of the great managers, a lot of them had very little, if any, major league experience as a player.
Now, in the case of Joe Maddon and a lot of other guys, Jim Leland would be in that in that picture. They couldn't have done that. And Joe admits it because he didn't have the gravitas as a player. He never got to the big leagues. Joe's 60? What do you say, 60 is the new 40? Yeah. Spent 31 years in the Angels organization. He was at the big league level at the very end as a coach. But he really paid his dues. He's at double digits, 10 strikeouts for Jimmy Nelson.
Every one of them has been swinging. He hasn't walked anybody. You just look at that. You see a guy's working in the fifth inning. He's got 10 punch outs and no walks. You say, well, does he have a no hitter going? Or do they scratch out a single? Cubs have hit three home runs.
Slider in the dirt, low and outside.
Yeah, Yeah, I think the quote Leland had about Craig Counsell was, you know, when I became a big league manager, I had to earn the respect of the players. A guy like Counsell, he's going to have to lose the respect of the players. He kind of has it going in. Yeah. You can lose it if you go in there and you're kind of a nut job. You're going to lose their respect.
Broken bat roller to Jeanette. And a 1-2-3 fifth, the second such inning for Nelson, but he's trailing 4-1 midway in the fifth.
With over 1,000 options and 60 finishes to choose from, you'll find the perfect cabinet hardware to easily update the look of your kitchen. Right now, they're all on sale. Update your kitchen with a new disposer from GE. Right now, they're all on sale. This half-horsepower model is only $68. This three-quarter-horsepower model with an extra-large grinding capacity is only $98.
Save big money at Menards.
Getting to the top is always a challenge. However, if you drive the award-winning Jeep Grand Cherokee or the versatile Jeep Cherokee, you'll realize the top is just the beginning. One drive and you'll discover why the Jeep brand continues to be the best-selling SUV brand. Join us now at the Jeep Drive and Discover event. During 1 week to deal, get an additional $500 bonus cash for a total cash allowance of $2,000 on Jeep Cherokee Latitude.
Chase Freedom. The card is for the essentials. The cash back is for the fun. Chase, so you can.
Hi, I'm David Kaplan here with a Coors Light Cold Hard Facts Sportsnet Central update. Blackhawks will be without defenseman Michael Roosevelt for the rest of the playoffs. He suffered a fractured ankle in last night's series clinching win against the Wild. The injury will require surgery. Cup post-game live coming up after the game. Holly joins me. Go back to Lennon, JD, and Miller Park in Milwaukee.
Thanks, Cap. Hamill to Nelson. Is that a hologram or something that kind of funky MB with fluorescent blue behind the mound? I can't see it from up here, but maybe. No, it's actually in chalk. Thought it was maybe some TV trick. And he's conveniently placed right behind the pitcher's rubber where we can't see it from our perch upstairs. Maybe it's frosted.
A little fondant.
Would that be bad form for an opposing pitcher to just walk up and step on it?
Probably, but I'd be tempted, wouldn't you? This season at Wrigley Field, the Cubs will feature Budweiser Bleacher Fridays on select dates throughout the season. Budweiser Bleacher Fridays will include pregame entertainment. Len's going to be out there juggling, as a matter of fact, at some point. Exclusive giveaway items, special food and beverages, and more. For more information and to buy your Budweiser Bleacher tickets, visit Cubs.com.
My juggling maximum of any object is two. I haven't quite graduated to three just yet. Hamill with five punch outs. We've seen 15 whiffs collectively. We're only in the fifth inning.
Chris Coughlin made a big play throwing out Adam Lind to end the first inning at home, and Hamill took over from there. Thanks for the lift, boys. Right back to doing what he typically does against this Brewer team. 5-0 lifetime against them in seven starts with a 220. 3-0 in this ballpark with a 135 ERA. 14 scoreless innings over two starts here last year.
Segura strikes out and then gives Montero a hug.
you know you're off balance when you almost fall down. And I guess he was just trying to get out of the way. Little embrace and on his way back to the dugout.
Jeanette, whose injury took 5 stitches, left hand laceration, a shower mishap, reaching for the body wash, cut his hand on the shower rack. The visitors clubhouse at PNC Park. That's bad luck.
Speaking of which, I had a shower mishap today.
Uh-oh.
The hotel. So you know how the hotel has the kind of the overhead rain showery thing?
Yeah.
And then the wand that's attached to the...
Yes.
And so I stepped in there just to get it started. I turned it on. It was on wand mode. It just blasted me right in the face.
Sorry to hear that.
Thought I would share.
Okay. But you're okay.
I'm good.
That's all that matters. Hamill starting to cruise with a 4-1 lead after 5.
Honda's the only company ever to win both the Indy 500
and a Supercross Racing Championship.
They were also the first to come up with this. The Honda Dream Garage Sales Event! Where you can get great deals on almost everything Honda makes, including the sporty Civic, named best value in its class. Get great deals on Civics right now!
Hurry, the Honda Dream Garage Sales Event ends soon. Get a great deal on a Civic today at your Honda dealer.
Lowe's presents How to Plan for the Future.
Happy Valentine's Day. Happy birthday. Sorry I forgot our anniversary. Happy Mother's Day.
1.5-gallon hanging baskets, now just 2 for $16 at Lowe's.
Heineken Light, the best light beer you've ever tasted, or I'll give you your money back. Not me. I won't. Someone will give you your money. Someone at Heineken, I'm guessing. Is it...
Hey, Hunter, need some pointers?
Just around the house.
Yeah, should do it then.
I love this free store pickup.
Yeah, it's also great when you're on tour. Just order online, we'll have it waiting for you the same day. You know, I bet there's an ace within a golf swing at just about anywhere.
Really?
Oh, you don't need to...
New mailboxes.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Getting help at Ace is like going to your neighbor.
Drive safely, Hunter.
Thanks again, Mike.
The internet is full of crazy stories and rumors. But when it comes to the Cubs, you can bet the farm. CSNChicago.com is bringing you the facts. From Cubs fans for Cubs fans. The Cubs page on CSNChicago.com. Brought to you by Wintrust.
How do you get to Wrigley Field? The Cubs suggest the use of public transportation, or for bike riders, use the Cubs courtesy bike check located near Clark and Addison. And for drivers, the Cubs provide free parking and shuttle service on night and weekend games from 3900 North Rockwell. For details, it's Cubs.com. Rizzo with a long home run to lead off the fourth inning.
Now we'll have to track down the exit velocity on this one.
Came in with a 10.27 OPS, good for fifth in the National League behind Adrian Gonzalez, Paul Goldschmidt, Jock Peterson, and Brewers first baseman tonight, Adam Lind. Hey, I've got to add a name to the early MVP race in the National League after this 0-2. Bounce towards second. Backhanded play, nicely done by Herrera. That'll go 5-3 in the shift. D. Gordon going into action tonight, batting a major league leading .437. He has 52 hits in his first 28 games. He hasn't even homered yet, JD, and he's slugging .521.
Yeah, he's been unbelievable. He's batting .509 in his home ballpark.
He's with the Marlins now. And following up that career year last year with the Dodgers, getting off to a great start in Miami.
Stolen 12 bases. Pretty good.
Strikeout and a double for Montero.
Alex Cobb done for the year. Tommy John surgery. Add him to a growing list. Put together a pretty good rotation of pitchers who are out for the year. Didn't miss by much. Homer Bailey's done. Yu Darvish, of course. Sausages are getting ready.
Yep. 2-1 on Montero. So the Mets will see them for four. Starting Monday at Wrigley Field. David Wright has some back issues. Delaying his return from the DL. He went to the shelf on April 15th with a strained hamstring. And Dylan G is going to the DL, which means Noah Syndergaard is expected to make his major league debut on Tuesday at Wrigley. How about that?
Well, they're very high in Syndergaard, one of the top pitching prospects in all of baseball. So we'll get a look up close and personal. Matt Harvey's pitching tonight. They got beat 3-1. He was looking to go 6-0, but Cole Hamels bested him this evening.
Syndergaard was in the news for a couple of different issues. Some Twitter flap. And then had the deal in spring training. Didn't David Wright kind of air him out? And the media heard it because he was in the clubhouse eating during a game. And the captain said, you should be on the bench. Lined, and that's caught.
Yeah, I don't remember. Yeah, I just know there's been some issues with him. Sometimes it takes a while for young guys to figure it out.
Hit a long home run in his last minor league start. So I think, if I'm not mistaken, I should look before I speak. We're going to see Harvey, right, Wednesday. We should see DeGrom.
Bartolo.
Didn't say Bartolo. Syndergaard. It might be the four we see in that series. Up to Sunday. And DeGrom also may pitch Monday. So I think, yeah, because they had an off day, I think they'll probably go Cologne. So it'll be DeGrom, Syndergaard, Harvey, Nice in the four games. So we could get Syndergaard, Arrieta, Harvey, Hamill. Sorry, DeGrom, Lester, Syndergaard, Arrieta, Harvey, Hamill. Not bad to start that series.
Hey, on L.A. Law, Harvey Hamill.
He was hairy, but close enough.
Starlin has punched out twice tonight. Seen a steady diet of these off-the-plate breaking balls.
Foul near the Cubs dugout.
He doesn't strike out much, Starlin Castro. He swings a lot and he chases a lot of pitches out of the zone, but he's very good at putting the ball in play. That's why Joe Maddon likes to play hit and run with him. He wouldn't do it here with two outs. Montero's going.
Popped up, back of short, and it's Segura for out number three. Sausages will race, and we'll be back for the bottom of the sixth, 4-1.
Some things are not what they appear to be. Other things are exactly what they appear to be. The 306 horsepower Lexus IS350. As aggressive as it looks. See your Chicago area and Northwest Indiana Lexus dealer.
Hey, I'm Chris Mars, host of That Sports Thing, the new show where I'll be talking sports with actors, comedians, and celebrity fans. It's That Sports Thing. And it's totally a thing now. Visit csnchicago.com for every new episode.
Paul, can you guys tuck in your shirts?
Why?
You look ridiculous.
Oh, but this is a smart casual
look. Yeah. Nope, nothing smart about looking sloppy.
You have to get rude about it.
Nice shirt.
Thank you. That is a nice shirt.
That's the look.
That's the one.
Nice shirt. What can I get you?
I'm gonna go ask him where he got his shirt.
National Tire and Battery's conventional oil change. We rotate your tires, check your battery, and visually check your brakes. All for $19.99 plus $3 disposal fee. Plus, now get the lowest installed price on tires guaranteed, including the Michelin Premier AS tire. Even when worn, they still stop shorter on wet roads than leading competitors' brand new tires. National Tire and Battery. That's all you need.
Cubs, Brewers, starting at 5:30 on CSN Chicago.
4-1 Cubs, bottom of the sixth. The Cubs baseball summer camps presented by ATI Physical Therapy are back. Give your kids an unforgettable baseball experience this summer. First camp kicks off in Lake Forest on June 22nd. Sign up at cubs.com/camps.
And they're off.
And down the stretch. Why don't we get Eddie Owen here to handicap this thing for us? Rizzo making a late push. Just edges out Bratwurst.
Brat is the worst runner, no question. Alan Braun.
This is actually a changeup, some kind of a let-up pitch. He just squirted away on Hamill. Still a little unsettling when it's up around your head if you're a hitter. It's a fastball. He probably doesn't get out of the way.
Good to see A-Rod hit 661 last night.
I heard it on the radio on my drive home.
Yeah.
It was an A-bomb from A-Rod.
He nearly hit one earlier. Delman Young in a home run saving catch.
Had come into that game 5 out of 10 with 3 home runs against Chris Tillman. So obviously sees the ball very well against Tillman.
The Yankees leading 5-4 in the bottom of the seventh tonight. Strike three call. Yankees won 4-3 last night.
A nice job here by Hamill after walking Braun twice. A little more aggressive with his approach this time and gets a call just off that inside corner to finish him off. Jason's been quite efficient. This is pitch number 70. And not really surprising, the Brewer team, for the most part, free swingers, don't take a lot of walks.
Shallow left field. Coughlin's there. Two outs. Blue Jays hitting coach Brooke Jacoby had his 14-game suspension upheld by Major League Baseball. He got into it apparently with Doug Eddings in the tunnel in Boston and was accused of putting his forearms up near Eddings' neck and pinning him against a wall. They have changed things in Boston now, so the visiting team has to wait until the umpire caught by the fan if he was reaching over the railing or not. And Rizzo asking the first base umpire, I think, about that very thing, Tom Hallion.
Until Madden not coming out,
yeah,
back behind him.
Joe actually is asking Tom Hallion. So it's not fan interference. If the ball is in the stands, a fan can go after it. But they could call it in that circumstance if the fan reaches onto the field of play, and Joe's saying, look, my guy is there.
Yeah, if the guy's,
he's going to catch it.
Yeah, especially if the guy's, you know, in a full-out sprint, you're not sure whether he's going to get in position to make a play or not. You probably don't call it, but if the player's settled under it and the fan reaches over, then it's fan interference.
So is this, you know, it's funny. I guess this is reviewable if they're asking the video guys to look at it.
But I wonder if the video guys have a look that we don't, because we don't have a real good look at it. I don't know if anybody does.
One and one.
You were talking about something.
Brooke Jacoby.
Oh, yeah,
they've changed it now, so the visiting team has to wait till the umpires have exited before they're allowed to, because yeah, you're just asking for it. And you commingle. Jacoby, in a statement released by the team, frustrations escalated, leading into an altercation. I was wrongly accused of contacting an umpire. I am in no way going to apologize for what happened. I feel that the penalties were very biased, harsh, and unfair. So he is sticking to his guns.
Yeah, he's denied laying hands on Eddings throughout this.
So he was suspended Monday. Started to serve the suspension. He appealed. They had the hearing today, and they said, nope, it's going to stick. 14 games. Jeremy Jeffress up in the Milwaukee bullpen.
Well, the coaches don't have a union. You know, so nobody really going to go to bat for Jacoby other than his own organization. I didn't even know coaches could appeal a suspension.
That one hit a ton by Chris Davis, and she's going to go. 4-2 on the Davis home run, his second.
Talked earlier about his home run potential. Really hadn't done much this year, just number two, but it's in there. Ball's jumping pretty good here tonight. All these balls have flown a long way. Fourth home run of the night. First by the Brewers. He sits back on that back leg, times it up perfectly. There's your Ford home run replay. Up above the Brewer bullpen. He had 22 home runs last year. Kind of got everybody's attention in 2013 when he hit 11 in only 136 at bats.
Yeah. Parra downs to Russell to end the inning. Two RBIs for Milwaukee, both belonging to Chris Davis. RBI single in the first. And a two-out homer here in the sixth. It's 4-2.
Little girl, you look so lonesome. I see you all feeling blue. Come on over to my place. Hey, girl, we're having a party. We'll be singing, dancing, and singing. Come on over tonight.
This is the day.
Have a day to remember. It's easy, with a free red velvet cake with a 10-piece meal or larger.
Why do I love coming to Chicago? Second City, the House of Blues, and Binney's Beverage Depot. Check out the prices, check out the volume, check out the enticements, check out these beautiful displays. If you can't find it at Binney's Beverage Depot, it's probably not worth drinking.
You're finally here. Long way from the sandlot. First game in the majors? You don't know ARP. Because this family is enjoying a cross-country baseball stadium trip they planned online at AARP Travel. It's where your journey begins with inspiration, planning, booking, and hot travel tips from real pros. If you don't think seize the trip when you think AARP, then you don't know ARP. Find more surprising possibilities and get to know us at aarp.org/possibilities.
Miller Park, Cubs leading 4-2. They went 1-3 in St. Louis. Chance to get back to two games over 500. They can hang on to this one as they will bat near the top of the seventh. Extra Fowler, two pitches in with a leadoff home run. That was a good start. The Cubs have hit three in all tonight.
Cubs lost two out of three last weekend to the Brewers, the first series win of the year for Milwaukee. Cubs looking to get things turned around and scuffling here of late. Frustrating series in St. Louis because they probably should have won three of the four and ended up losing just the, or winning just the one.
So yeah, fan interference is covered under replay. We had not seen one quite like the one we just saw in the last half inning that was not reviewed. They couldn't get a good shot. One away here in the seventh. So the other night in St. Louis, both managers lost their challenge in the first inning, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which means no replay review in that situation could be had until the seventh inning. That would have to be a crew chief review. The one exception is the boundary call. At any point during the game, the crew chief, if it's fuzzy as to whether or not a ball was a home run or not, which is how replay began.
Right, that was a very...
That can happen at any time. Crew chief has sole discretion to initiate a review of a potential home run.
Look at this guy hit.
Segura will get him. Hamill, 1-3 tonight. You know, we laugh, but his prowess at the plate here early on in the season, J.D., may buy him another inning down the road on the mound.
Yeah.
I think Joe would give him another inning the way he's swinging the bat.
If you got a halfway decent chance to compete in the batter's box, a manager might leave you in there in a given situation. We expect the Cubs staff to be a pretty good hitting staff. So far they haven't. They're like 104, I think I looked earlier.
Russell's got a 10-gamer on the line. He has flied out and struck out, hitting 343 during this 10-game hit streak.
Travis Wood, of course, expected to lead the way when it comes to pitchers hitting.
Perennial Silver Slugger candidate. And he's good for at least one homer per year. Still waiting for that this season. As Russell strikes out and will stretch here in Milwaukee, the Cubs lead the Brewers 4-2.
Every pitcher has a different routine. Before I pitch, I hit Subway for my go-to. Have for years. Fresh made turkey and cheese on 9-grain wheat with jalapenos, mustard, and a little bit of vinegar. Followed by a steady diet of fastballs.
Cubs lead a 4-2 now. Brewers to bat in the bottom of the seventh. Visit the Cubs Authentics auction page now for your chance to own a game. Use Chris Bryant bat, Jake Arrieta jersey, and more. This week's auction closes Sunday at 8 p.m. Go to Cubs.com/authentics to place your bids. Cubs will donate net proceeds from the sale of Cubs Authentics to Cubs charities.
And our most important question on Twitter tonight. What is your favorite encased meat product at Miller Park? You are eating one of those.
I'm working
products.
On a brat. Every time these silly mascots race, it's like Pavlov. Oh, I need to go have a brat.
Yeah, I'm in the brat camp myself. With the stadium mustard.
I got the remnants of a brat here.
Yes. Very nice.
Yeah. A rally brat.
One 0 to Maldonado is a strike. So two run ball game. We're in the seventh. Kind of a heightened sense in the dugout with a two run lead late. And so the bullpen is starting to get busy. Backhanded play. Castro has got time and he gets Maldonado. Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it? If this game is 2-0 and the Brewers don't have a hit, there's nobody up in the bullpen. Because that's what baseball people do. But because it's 4-2 and he is not flirting with any sort of history, you can get somebody up and it doesn't matter if he sees it or not. Mm-hmm. It kind of doesn't make sense.
No, you know, I've heard both schools of thought. I've talked to pitching coaches. Go, don't ever get anybody up when a guy's pitching a no hitter. And other guys are like, hey, it's a 1-0 ball game, and you know things can unravel in a hurry. Because if you're the guy in the mound pitching that game, you shouldn't be all that concerned or really aware of what's going on out in the bullpen.
And what are you going to do? Blame somebody? Well, you had somebody up.
Yeah.
That's why I gave up two hits.
Yeah. You were assuming I was going to give it up. Got a piece of Herrera, so he's going to take a little time here to let the pain subside. Well, the Cardinals pressing on. And in the bottom of the ninth in Pittsburgh, St. Louis leads the Pirates 8-5. Wong, Peralta, and Holiday have all homered.
Cut and a miss, strike three.
I believe all of those off starter Francisco Liriano, so he's having kind of a Nelson night. He's only allowed 6 hits. He struck out 10, but 6 runs, 5 earned because of the long balls.
Juan Centeno, a catcher, will pinch hit for Nelson. Former Met, left-handed batter. For 8 with 4 strikeouts.
Nelson was really good tonight. 7 innings, 5 hits, 4 runs, a walk, 11 strikeouts. Long balls got him. His trend of giving it up a little bit in the rematch of these back-to-back starts continues to an extent here tonight, but he was about as good tonight as he was in Chicago.
Line to Bryant to end the inning. So Hamill still strong through 7 with a 4-2 advantage.